All right, party people, this is Little America, Wyoming. Big truck stop. In the wintertime, this place can just ice over. But occasionally, when you come back here too, you can see, you know, I used to take my dog for long walks way back out. And there's a little water body, a body of water over there, rather. Water body. A lot of pronghorn out there walking around. Let's see if we can, if there are any stirring up today. See any today, but in the past a couple times I've seen herds out there got getting a drink and they're eating the grass or whatever they're doing. You know, I take my dog out there on her long leash and she would kind of bark at him or want to go play with them, and they would of course start running, and when they run funny because their heads are just kind of back a little bit when they're running full speed. And it would just excite her, like get her all amped up. And the hunter, the deep down DNA hunter in her would go, "Oh, Dad, let me loose. I want to go chase the pronghorns." Nah, leave them alone. Come on. I think we're going to go park over here because we want to face east. Those are kind of southeast. This is due south. And I spied a couple, oh, there's a spot over there. That might be a better choice, closer to the, see, I was looking at these spots right here are facing east that way. Do they let trucks park over here? I think so. Probably right here, right next to this crosshatch. Good spot. Make it easy. We got lots of room in front of us. Problem is, I should have missed it. Well, these guys park, they're pushing down, they're making ruts in the parking spots. That's why I was getting rocked by running perpendicular on those. Okay, got it back. See the puppies? Oh, I wish I had my dog, man. And he's got a real long leash on that dog. And they got a puppy area caged in, you know, fenced in for the dogs to run loose, free. And they can socialize. I found that dogs socialize better when they're off the leash. If you have two dogs on a leash, or one dog on a leash and one dog off the leash, the dog on the leash feels restricted and it changes their dynamic. Their body language changes, and if you pull on their collar a little bit or their leash, it could send the wrong signal to the other dog. And because they think, oh, you're being aggressive to me, or your body language says something different than what is supposed to be said, and the dogs can go into a fighting mode. So, but in a dog park like that, I always found that they did really well off the leash. The dogs, because they could speak to each other with their body language and their and whatever how they look at each other, and. They're fine. And they also have an escape route. They also have their full speed to run away if necessary. Or lie down and expose their belly, you know how they're submissive. But still, I've seen some pretty nasty dog fights at dog parks. You know, that usually what happens is somebody brings food in, snacks for their dog, and then they want to start giving snacks to your dog. I'm like, don't, please don't, no. Don't bring snacks in here. Don't bring snacks to the dog park. It just creates problems.